This programming is sponsored by the Bayou Theater at the University of Houston Clear Lake, announcing their new season, featuring a variety of music, dance, theater, and comedy performances. Tickets at uhcl.universitytickets.com.
Welcome to Encore Houston on Houston Public Media. I'm Joshua Zinn, and this week we'll feature performances from the Round Top Music Festival in 2019, highlighting chamber music by Bruckner, Dvorak, and Mahler. Gustav Mahler is best known for his larger symphonic works. He has 9 finished symphonies and some orchestral art songs and song cycles, but he has at least one surviving chamber piece from his early career, the Piano Quartet in A minor. This is a one-movement piece that may have been intended for a larger work, but it ultimately just exists as this single movement. Here it is performed by faculty musicians from the 2019 Round Top Music Festival.
Thank you.
Gustav Mahler's Piano Quartet in A Minor. You heard Round Top Music Festival musicians Thomas Kotick, Brett Dubner, Stephen Balderston, and Vladimir Valyarevic performing in 2019. I'm Joshua Zinn, and this is Encore Houston. Similar to his friend Gustav Mahler, the late Romantic era composer Anton Bruckner is probably best known for his larger ensemble works like symphonies and masses. But he also has a handful of chamber works to his name, like this string quintet for two violins, two violas, and cello. And if you're familiar with Bruckner, you might know his proclivity for long, robust pieces of music, and this quintet is no exception, almost as if he's writing a full symphony for this smaller ensemble. Here are musicians from the Round Top Music Festival once again.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
The Quintet for Strings in F by Anton Bruckner. You heard violins Thomas Kotick and Haley Ju, violas Brett Dubner and Cristiano Rodriguez, and cellist Stephen Balderston, all part of the 2019 Round Top Music Festival performing at Festival Concert Hall. You're listening to Encore Houston on Houston Public Media. As we've just heard, through much of the classical and romantic eras, chamber music typically featured piano or strings with the occasional appearance of wind instruments. Chamber music for wind ensembles became much more popular in the 20th century, but there are a few notable examples prior to that time, like this serenade by Antonín Dvořák. Interestingly, Dvořák may have been inspired by another notable example of this type of piece in Mozart's Serenade for Wind Instruments, even going so far as to include the same kind of instrumentation of oboes, flutes, clarinets, bassoons, horns, and two string instruments in cello and bass. Here are the combined forces of faculty and young artists at the Round Top Music Festival with the Serenade for Winds and Double Bass.
Thank you. Thank you.
The Serenade for Winds and Double Bass by Antonin Dvorak, performed by musicians at the Round Top Music Festival in June of 2019, led by conductor Jason Thomas Aylward. Although the Round Top Music Festival takes place during the summer, Festival Concert Hall in Round Top, Texas, hosts a number of performances throughout the year. You can find a schedule at festivalhill.org. The recording engineer for these performances was Andy Bradley, and Mark DiClaudio does the mix for the show. I'm Joshua Zinn, and this has been Encore Houston. Thanks for listening to Houston Public Media.
This programming is sponsored by the UH Health Family Care Center, offering primary care and behavioral health services on the University of Houston campus. Health insurance plans, including Medicare and Medicaid, accepted. New patient appointments and more at 832-UH-CARES.